Sorry to see the Russians not coming.
How about Central America?
We have a press conference. Oh, it's coming up, I think, very shortly.
When?
When?
President Mathias, Mayor Hopalodino.
Haven't set the final date. I'll answer many of your questions in my speech tonight.
What are you going to say tonight about the threat of the Soviets?
Tune in.
Have it safe for Hopalodino.
Some good in everybody. Well, it was another scary step, I know, in the continuing efforts of the Salvadorans to come before democracy, and I understand that you have combat very enthusiasm by what you saw. And I know that we can't go into all those details. And for a few minutes here to the right for that. Then I am looking forward to hearing a reply from all of you. What you saw and what you learned. It seems to me that there's obviously no question about their enthusiasm. I mean the rank and file, the grassroots enthusiasm down there for folks who are going to be late. Maybe I'll have to start talking about Chandon.
Mr. President, could you give us a little preview of what's going to be in your speech tonight?
I wouldn't spoil the surprise for anything in the world.
Is it going to be a surprise?
I just think it's some things that need to be made a little more clear.
Mr. President, you haven't spoken out yet personally on the Soviets not attending the Olympics. What was your reaction when you heard that yesterday?
Well, now, I'm not supposed to answer any questions here in the press or photo opportunity, but I think I can't let that go by without saying that, like so many, I have a great feeling of disappointment. Sorry that they feel that way, and I think it's unfair to the young people that have been waiting for so long to participate in those games. And it ought to be remembered by all of us that the games were 2,000 years ago started as a means of bringing peace between the Greek city-states. And in those days, even if a war was going on, when Olympic year came, they called off the war in order to hold the games. I wish we were still civilized.
Vice President, thank you. Well, maybe the first time the games were truly amateur in a long time.
Especially being here in California.
Well, it's not the security they worry about, it's the defection.
That's part of it. Possibly some revenge. Ourselves making the same mistake, but I think also that defection thing must be. I heard an observation in the air this morning. Someone pointed out, counted up the medals, that the normal, the average that they've gotten in previous Olympics, gold medals, and what they got when we weren't there, doubled their normal average, and that maybe they also don't want to be counted as having gone back down. Well, I'm interested in hearing from all of you.
Well, Mr. President, let me just briefly say, and then I hope everybody will speak out. We came back extremely impressed by the elections, by the professionalism of those who are running the different polling places, by the patience and determination of those who voted. They were voting.
Mr. President, how are you?
Good. Well, let's go ahead and sit down here for a minute.
Before we do, could I get you to take a picture? I've got one this one.
Oh?
Come here, guys. I've got one. I want a picture of you. That thing.
All right.
One more. Thanks. I'm a friend. If I had one, I would have a photograph.
I've always said that I'm glad. So I'm glad that Benjamin Franklin, I think I've got him right as to which one it was, didn't have his way. He wanted turkey to be the national bird.
That's right. I think I heard you tell us.
And I've always figured that I don't think those would have tasted good. Glad we're eating the one and we have this one for the
symbol. Well, you look like you're over the jet lag.
I'm not quite sure. It's been amazing, and all of us have been comparing notes. And like, we were up at Camp David for a couple of days, and I thought back on track, slept well. And then all of a sudden, back down here, and I turned off the lights thinking I'd go to sleep, and at 2 o'clock in the morning, I was still awake. Then went to sleep, but at 6 o'clock, I was awake again, came in, and found that half the people that had been on the trip had exactly the same experience on the same night. Now, last night, I slept all the way straight through, had a good night's sleep, and found myself late this morning, beginning to blink. I couldn't keep my eyes open. So when I got over to lunch over there with the president of Botswana, I'm a decaffeinated coffee drinker. I said to the fellow, sir, bring me the real thing.
President, good morning.
Good.
See you again. Secretary is still in Korea, so I'm on duty.
Right about now, I envy him.
You're off that Korean time, aren't you?
No, it's just weird. Night before last, I went to bed, and I right at bedtime, and I went to sleep. I slept right straight through the night, had a good solid night's sleep. And then yesterday, just about the time President Masiri was here, I sat here and I was fighting to keep my eyes open. And then I looked at my watch and realized, right at that time, about 11 o'clock, it was bedtime in China.
Yeah.
So that even though it had a good night's sleep, that we already got used to their time. And pretty soon it passed and went away. So when I went home, I checked, and Nancy said she had the same experience. Well, I know what...
I'm trying to say something shocking and outrageous, Mr. President, so you won't go to sleep on it. Dr. Hollander.
I'm on it.
Well,
Mr. President.
Good to see you,
Mr. President. One of the Fermi Award winners, and Dr. Lawrence.
Good morning, President.
Hello.
Nice to see you, sir. And Mrs. Hollander.
How do you do?
Happy
to meet you. Nice to see you. Well, I know that you've kind of had your awards divided into installments here, but I'm very happy that you did so that I could at least participate a little bit and be able to give my congratulations and thanks to you. So, while the rest has been already presented, these are the citations. And I'm very honored and pleased to present them to you. So
thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you for your contribution.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's nice to be in the White House.
I've
got a great staff here.